133 days, we are finally just one game away from crowning the first champions of Season 1 of the U Cypher League. Nail-biting games, deadly face-offs, old rivalries.
That's the guy.
आपके छोटे भाई ने आपको हराया था.
Brothers fighting against each other. Brothers fighting alongside each other. Roller coaster of emotions. Heartfelt defeats. And some astounding victories. Two teams, the Yakshas and the Sherdils, have faced off against some of the best gamers of the country, and this is their road to the finale.
Welcome to Ucypher Esports League's drafting process. May the best bid win.
At the start of the tournament, the six captains went through an intense bidding war to buy players for each game and create their respective teams. This involved some serious calculations as the captains were only allotted limited points, with some of the biggest names of gaming in the player pool. And this gave us the first six teams of U Cypher Season 1. Akramax, Crusaders, the Marksmen, Sherdils, Yakshas, and the Yodhas. Each team would face each other twice in a round-robin league format. Six teams of 14 players each compete in four games. Counter-Strike, Global Offensive, Dota 2, Tekken 7, and Real Cricket 17. And the top four teams on the leaderboard would qualify for the semi-finals. Round one of the round robin league was kicked off by the Yakshas versus the Marksmen. The calm and confident Vivek Akrid facing off against the aggressive yet calculative captain Ankit Venom. Both the teams had some well-known players from the gaming community. From the Yakshas, Akrid was an already established Indian Dota legend, while the Counter-Strike team had two well-known rivals, Skadoosh and Impale, playing on the same side.
I heard about both of you, Skadoosh and Sneeze, having been rivals before this.
Yes, we were. We don't like each other, that everyone knows here. But it's just that we are matured enough to eat up our egos.
Only time would tell if Impale's level-headedness would balance the explosive nature of in-game leader Skadoosh. For Real Cricket, it was a shy but composed iBot. For Tekken, it was a player better known in the gaming community as a football legend, Jaunty Tank.
His name is Jaunty Tank, Tank of Destruction.
Tank has been playing Tekken for just 3 months, and that would clearly be a challenge, since from Marksman for Tekken, it would be Devraj Checkmate Pandey, an established Tekken player and coach. For Real Cricket, it would be the quiet Takuroi. The Counter-Strike team had some deadly shooters in the form of the team captain Venom and Rix. The Dota team of the Marksmen was a group of younger talent, one of them being Arshad Mage Khan. This was going to be an explosive start to the first season of the U Cypher League.
All is on target.
Go Marksmen!
All is on target.
Go Marksmen!
All is on target.
Go Marksmen!
Let's go!
Yakshas!
Let's go!
Yakshas!
Let's go!
Yakshas!
And the face-off lived up to its expectations. Tekken started off the fireworks with the experienced Devraj facing a straight defeat at the hands of Jaunty Tank. Yeah. And the surprises continued with iBot getting the better of Takuroid in Real Cricket. With a lead of 6 points, the Yakshas clearly had strong competitors in the single-player games, and now it was the turn of the more established legends of the high-scoring multiplayer games to live up to their reputation. The first shock for the Yakshas came in Counter-Strike. The Yakshas lost with an embarrassing scoreline of 16-4. But the final nail in the coffin would be Mage, who blew away all the strategies of the Yakshas captain Acrid in Dota, helping Marksmen draw first blood and take a lead of 10-6 on the overall leaderboard. Day 2 would see the Yodhas go up against the Sherdils.
Both of you are CSGO players and you have played together in a team as well.
Yes.
Right? So what was that like?
Like a legendary period for us. We were together since past 5 years and wahan se hum non-stop jeette hi aaye.
The Yodhas, led by their captain Pranay Vaz Bhatia, would be taking headshots along with his brother Kunal Peksar Bhatia. For Tekken, it would be the football freestyler and record holder Ashish Crispy and Sachin Kunwao in real cricket.
कुछ बोलना अपने ओपोनेंट को?
बेटा हारने के लिए रेडी रहना.
Oh, confidence!
Sachin! Sachin!
The Dota team of the Yodhas were a much younger bunch of unknown faces, rallied together by their in-game leader Rishabh 11. Unlike the Sherdils, who were going to start with the Tekken legend Hans.
Hans obviously is a legend in Tekken. ये मैच उसके लिए प्रैक्टिस मैच ही रहेगा.
Anoop aggressive for cricket. Dota would be led by Mamacita, and the Counter-Strike team was filled with famous fraggers, including Captain Ritz, Buster, and an even more established Falcon. Luckily for the Yodhas, Falcon would not be in the lineup since he was representing India in Malaysia for Counter-Strike, but it was still going to be a tough fight. Day 2 started as expected for the Sherdils, with Hans wiping the floor with Archies. But the Sherdils received a setback in real cricket with aggressive losing against Kunwao. With the scores tied at 3-3, the multiplayer games would decide the outcome. The Yodhas under the Bhatia brothers cruised to a well-fought victory in Counter-Strike. But Sherdils under Mamacita managed to pull back 5 points in Dota, leaving the final scores tied at 8-8. However, this put both Yodhas and the Sherdils tied at the number 2 spot on the leaderboard, pushing the Yakshas back to 4th. Day 3, it was the Akramaks going up against the Crusaders. The Crusaders were led by Atul Remstar.
U Cypher ke liye maine bahut sacrifices kiye abhi. I had to quit my job as well, just to, because of the tournament and the long structure of the tournament, I had to quit it.
He would also be leading their Dota team, which included the youngest player of the U Cypher League, Invincible. Tekken would be played by the notoriously named Aussie.
Confidence to hai Osama pe. Osama phodne ke liye kafi famous hai. Aaj bhi phodega Osama.
While Killer B would be in charge of Real Cricket 17, the Crusaders Counter-Strike team was led by Kavish and Krish. While on the other hand, the Akramaks had a CS team with members of one of India's leading Counter-Strike teams, including Manan, Mithil F, and the sharp-tongued, ever-sarcastic team captain and Counter-Strike in-game leader, Kappa.
Kappa, was this the plan from the beginning?
Kya?
To scare everybody?
Wo to pehle se dare hua hai. Wo darane ki zarurat nahi hai.
With a relatively unknown Dota team and a newcomer to Tekken, Afro Ninja, the Akramaks depended heavily on their intimidating wildcard, Love SX, a legendary PlayStation footballer trying his hand at cricket. The Akramaks started the day with a bang as Afro Ninja destroyed Aussie in Tekken. Love SX dominated Killer B, and Kappa and his CS squad left the Crusaders eating their dust. Trailing 11-0, the Crusaders were looking at a clean sweep, but their Dota in-game leader steered their team to a smooth victory, picking up 5 valuable points from the day. At the end of every team playing once, the Akramaks shot to the top of the table, with Crusaders trailing at the bottom. Day 4, the Yakshas went up against the Yodhas. Again, strong performances from Jaunty Tank and iBot gave Yakshas all the 6 points from the single player gains. Rivals Kadoosh and Impale couldn't bring the team together once again. Second time in a row, they ended up in single digits and lost 5 points in CS after a great performance by the Bhatia brothers. But under Captain Acrid, the Yakshas managed to pull back 5 points, winning the day 11-5. Day 5 was the Battle of the Giants, with 2 of the best Counter-Strike teams of the tournament, the Marksmen versus the Akramak. Both big winners in their first matches looked confident, but Devraj got the better of Afro Ninja, and after the first super over of the tournament, LoveSX lost a hard-fought game of real cricket against Takaroid. The Akramaks seemed confident in making it up in Counter-Strike. But Akramaks, with some of the best shooters of the country, had no answer to the cunningness of the Marksman in-game leader, Venom himself. Last game, Dota and Akramaks once again failed to get any points in Dota.
Time in U Cypher, we have a clean sweep, which means the Marksmen have won all 4 games of the day.
This game, Marksmen got a nice lead on the leaderboard. Day 6 put the Crusaders against the Sherdils. Crusaders, lagging at the bottom of the table, needed to score big, but their single players under Kapish and Krish, the Crusaders managed to pull back 5 points in CS. The Sherdils clearly missing their star player Falcon, but Remstar, the Crusaders captain and Dota player, decided to bench himself out, which proved to be a clear mistake, and the Sherdils took the day 11-5. After 2 games each, the Marksmen, with their clean sweep, were far ahead with 26 points. Day 7, and it's the Akramaks versus the Yakshas. The Akramaks, after their embarrassing performance, regrouped as a team. The Akramaks destroyed the Yakshas 16-2 in CS, leaving the Yakshas CS team in shambles. The Yakshas took the single player games but had no answers in CS and Dota.
What a comeback, Kappa. You guys are now 2nd on the leaderboard. Today, the Akramaks have earned 10 points and you guys have earned 6. Good job, guys. Congratulations and all the best.
The battle at the bottom of the table heated up on day 8. This proved to be a dead rubber, with Aussie losing Tekken again. But Killer B won his first cricket match, drawing the single player games. The Bhatia brothers got the better of the Crusaders in CS, but Remstar, coming off the bench, equaled the day off with a win in Dota. Day 9, and this was a chance for the Marksmen to take a bigger lead on the leaderboard, and an even bigger chance for Ritz to beat his arch rival, Venom.
Falcon is back.
Yeah, finally.
So how do you feel about that?
Falcon basically our team's backbone. He was the MVP. And today's day, I needed him. Because Ankit, I can't see him winning.
I know you guys don't like talking to each other, and I really want to know why. When did this rivalry start?
It's a revenge, basically.
Revenge?
Yeah, we started playing and we defeated them. Then I think the downfall started and we dominated it for a year. After that, picked it up and they formed different teams. So maybe you can say that we were the reason of the split up.
While Dota would have 2 brothers going up against each other.
Do these 2 look related to you? Well, that's because they are. Mate, are you going to go easy on your bro or what?
Doesn't matter.
Doesn't matter.
Devraj went down easily under the brutality of Hans. But the rest of the Marksmen rallied together to crush the Sherdils 11-3. Marksmen were clearly dominating the first season of the U Cypher League But day 10 saw close friends Acrid and Remstar going up against each other. However, all the brotherhood went out of the window as the Yakshas thrashed the Crusaders 16-0. This win put them right at the top of the leaderboard with the marksmen. Day 11 was another battle of brothers.
आज
आक्रामक सेम इन इनफैक्ट सारे प्लेयर्स मेरे फ्रेंड्स भी है और मेरे टीममेट्स भी रह चुके हैं कप्पा मेरा भाई भी है और दोस्त भी है तो आज थोड़ा मजा आएगा
दिस वाज गोना बी अ माउथ वाटरिंग बैटल
मैं एज अ इन गेम लीडर स्टेप डाउन हो रहा हूं और मैं खुद से ही अभी अटैक पे ही चालू करना चाहता हूं वापस
सो हु इज गोना रिप्लेस यू
फाल्कन
फाल्कन Now that he's back clearly.
But only Love Essex managed to get any points as Ritz and his younger team managed to destroy four of his ex-teammates from the Akramaks.
लोग ने सोचा नहीं था कि वो लोग इतना अच्छा खेलेंगे फाल्कन उसने काफी अच्छा लीड किया उसके टीम को और हम लोग अगली बार के लिए ये याद रखेंगे
Winning the day 13-3 two clear halves could be seen in the leaderboard with the Akramaks heading for a fight out with the bottom of the table. Day 12 put two close friends, Venom and Woods, against each other. The single player points were split equally, while Venom got the better of the Bhatia brothers, winning Counter-Strike yet again. Marksman had won all their CS matches till now, while on the Yodha side, losing three Dota games back to back, Rishabh 11 finally stepped up his game and took the Yodhas team to victory.
Yodhas, you took the victory home. Your third tie in U Cypher. As a captain, how pissing off is that?
It's not all pissing off. I really enjoyed the game. I'm proud of my boys.
So it was fun competing with Yodhas?
Yes, definitely.
Day 13 was the first face-off between our two current finalists. At this stage, Hans, Jaunty and iBot remained unbeaten in their games.
Tekken 7 mein sabse zyada awaited match. Jaunty Tank versus Hans.
Hans finally ended Jaunty's streak in Tekken, leaving him in tears.
Ucypher mein undefeated in Tekken 7. How does it feel?
It feels great, man.
Aaj tak Jaunty Tank ko kisi ne nahi haraya.
नहीं तो हार के ही तो बंदा सीखता है मतलब मैं भी शुरुआत में बहुत हारता था
गुरुदेव गुरुदेव क्या शिक्षा दी आपने इनको आज
While iBot maintained his winning record, beating a poor Anoop Aggressive in five games. Both the Counter-Strike teams of Yakshas and the Sherdils were still finding their feet, winning just one game of CS from four.
भद्दे प्लेयर्स है एकदम उनसे हारना नहीं है
ठीक है
जीतने के बाद उनके सामने जाके चिल्लाना है उनको
लेट्स गो आउट देयर विन दिस वन एज वेल एंड शो देम अंडरडॉग्स बोला ना दिखाते हैं वो लोग को अंडरडॉग्स कौन है टूर्नामेंट
चलो
Skadoosh and Impale again failed to find their form and couldn't handle a re-energized Sherdils
I think it was a great game for us today because lots of learning and great effort by my team but it's okay now it comes to Dota so It's my game, so I'm all set for it.
Your boys ready?
Yeah, they were always ready.
Acrid took back the day with a win in Dota, making it 8-8 and keeping the Yakshas toe-to-toe with the Marksmen on the leaderboard. Day 14 gave the Marksmen the chance to consolidate their position as they were facing an out-of-form Crusader.
What is the plan to creep in up on that table, man?
Still now we have six matches and every league has this team that, you know, writes the story of an epic comeback. So I think so Crusader is this there for this league and we are going to make this comeback and comeback is real guys.
The Marksmen took Tekken, Cricket and Dota but suffered their first shock defeat in Counter-Strike at the hands of Kavish and Krish. Day 15 saw the Akramaks going against the Yodhas. Akramaks took a lead of 11 points, winning Tekken, Cricket and CS. But the Yodhas Dota team came back to snatch 5 points, making it 11-5. The end of this match ended the first half of the round robin. Marksmen managed to come out on top at this stage, with the Akramaks, Yodhas and the Crusaders reeling at the bottom.
We have finished our first complete round of matches, and before we move into the second one, I'd like you to have a look at our current leaderboard. By now, every team has played against other teams at least once.
And we are here to start the first match of the second round robin.
In the first match of round robin 2, we saw Team Yakshas going up against Team round Marksman. One. This was truly the one match to look out for, as both the teams were equally strong. The match, as expected, kept us all on the edge of our seats, and Yakshas proved to be the underdogs.
And that's a biggie directly out of the stadium. It's a six.
They performed really well and took away the first position from the marksmen. And after a very long time,
first match of the second round robin and the Yakshas took over.
And the scores at the end of the day are marksmen at 3 and Yakshas at 13. And uske saath saath obviously leaderboard mein kaafi zyada changes aaye. Take a look.
In the second match of round robin 2, Team Sherdils and Team Yodhas got the chance to show their skill sets.
Fight.
Both the teams gave in their all, and this one was like a roller coaster. If Sherdils won Tekken, the Yodhas won real cricket. By the end of the Counter-Strike match, Sherdils looked promising for the win. But again, Yodhas surprised us all by winning Dota. Both the teams put up a great show, but the match ended in a tie. Day 18, the Crusaders went up against the Akramaks. As always, the Crusaders lost the single-player matches. Under the strong leadership of Kappa, the Akramaks destroyed the Crusaders in CS as well. But Captain Remstar proved his worth by taking back 5 points in Dota, making it 11-5. Day 19 was the Yodhas versus the Yakshas.
Fight.
Jaunty and Ibot from the Yakshas took the single player games. And after a closely fought game, Yakshas made it 11-0 in Counter-Strike. But the Yodhas, under in-game leader 11, won Dota and made it 11-5. Day 20 put the Crusaders up against the Sherdils.
Fight!
Hans gained off Ozzy from the Crusaders, while the rarely performing Anoop Aggressive won real cricket. The biggest shock was the powerful Sherdil CS team fell against the Crusaders. While Crusaders' strong Dota team faced defeat at the hands of the Sherdils. But a score of 11-5 pushed the Sherdils up to the second position on the leaderboard. Team Akramaks finally got the much-awaited chance for a revenge match against Team Marksman.
K.O. K.O.
But they rallied back to win Counter-Strike. More surprisingly, they even won Dota. The Akramaks finally climbed into the top 4 places on the leaderboard. Once again, the bottom 2 teams, Yodhas and Crusaders, were to face each other.
What?
both teams were under great pressure as they wanted to prove that they belonged in the U Cypher League. History was created in the league because finally, Team Yodhas for the very first time could manage a victory against a team in the U Cypher League.
It's been a game-changing day of gaming for both our teams today. The Yodhas finally managed to break their cycle of either losing or drawing by winning their first match ever on U Cypher, securing them a spot in the championship.
Day 23, and another vengeful match for Team Akramax. And this time, it was against the Team Yakshas.
Fight!
Throughout the match, the Akramax tried too hard for the win, but the Yakshas were too strong to be defeated by anyone. They secured their top position on the leaderboard, with the Akramax managing to stay in the fight for top four. Another interesting match on day 24 between the Marksmen and the Sherdils. And it was interesting since everyone knew about the rivalry between the two captains, Venom and Ritz. And as always, Hans demolished Checkmate and became the most consistent Tekken player throughout the league.
Amazing shot from Thakur Rohit. It's a six. And that's a wicket. He is out. Gonna destroy Rex, but here's a sacrifice. Not so good.
This truly was a takkar ka match, where the Sherdils won Tekken and Dota, while the Marksmen took cricket and Counter-Strike, drawing the day 8-8. Day 25 was the last chance for the Crusaders to stay in the league.
Fight!
And that's direct on the bat, and now it's going for a six. And he missed another one.
Though the Crusaders lost again to the Team Yakshas, they looked stronger than before. The Yakshas cemented their place at the top of the leaderboard, and clearly by now, the teams were feeling the pressure as it was getting close to the semi-finale. Day 26, and one more time, the Akramax went up against the Sherdils.
Fight.
This one proved to be a shocker for everyone as Afro Ninja managed to take one set against Hans in a Tekken game. On the other side, Aggressive beat Sagar Vyas to win cricket. But In the end, our Kramak lost to the Sherdils, but secured their fourth position on the leaderboard. Sherdils moved up to the second position, pushing the marksmen to the third spot. Day 27 was the marksmen versus the Yodhas.
Fight!
This match that got the marksmen back to their second spot on the leaderboard. Also, where Yodhas yet again proved they were one of the strongest Dota team in this league. And 11 was truly the man to look out for in his future Dota games. Day 28 put the Yakshas up against the Sherdils. This proved to be one of the most intense matches of the tournament. Both the teams clearly put their heart and souls along with their brains and hard work, keeping us at the edge of our seats.
KO.
But in the end, Yakshas became the first and only team to cross 100 points in the tournament, securing their top position on the leaderboard. Day 29 was the most crucial match for the Akramaks and the Yodhas, because this match would decide which one of these two teams would qualify for the semis. The Akramaks thrashed the Yodhas in Tekken, cricket, and then Counter-Strike. 11 could only save the Yodhas' face by winning Dota, but it was too late for them to make it to the top 4. For the last match of Round Robin 2, Team Crusaders went up against the Marksmen. Though clearly by now, the Crusaders were out of the tournament, it was the last chance for them to leave with their heads held high. Crusaders lost Tekken and cricket, but in an impossible turn of events, the Crusaders beat the Marksmen in both Counter-Strike and Dota. And with a heavy heart, Team Marksmen dropped to the number 3 position on the leaderboard, but was still in the semis. This brought us to the end of the Round Robin League, with the Yakshas, Sherdils, Marksmen and the Akramaks making it to the semi-finals of Season 1 of U Cypher. Now, it was the time for the semi-finals.
Kuch bhi ho jaye, history banne wali.
First team to cross 100 and the only team to cross 100.
In the first semi-finale, it would be the Akramaks going up against the Yakshas.
I'm here to draw the first blood, like I always do.
Concentration se hatna nahi mujhe, isliye kuch bolunga.
Looks like this is gonna be a perfect. Katrina is gonna knock her out. He has the rage art but couldn't do anything, as Yakshas are gonna end the game with a perfect.
Yakshas started the day by taking 3 points in Tekken, and the next game was Counter-Strike.
And there it goes.
मेरे players का नाम देख के वो लोग की फट जाती है और खौफ तो वो लोग के दिल में भी है. वो लोग का vice captain IGL कुछ नहीं सकते हम लोग का. और हमें पता था इसके लिए वो लोग double digit तक भी नहीं पहुंच सकते हम लोग के सामने.
SMX comes in from the vents and erases him off, and Akramaks win the game.
After a strong performance as always, the Akramaks went on to win CS, making it 3-5 in their favor.
And that's a huge hit towards the boundary. It's a 6. He misses it directly in the audience. It's a 6. 3 runs. Akramaks now need 28 runs to win this game. And that's a huge hit by Sagar Vyas. It's a 6. 4th ball of the over. And he misses the shot. So the Yakshas win the game.
And then iBot made it 6-5 for the Yakshas. It all came down to Dota.
Let me just remind you that everything is going to boil down to our last multiplayer game, Dota 2.
CSGO मेरे फेवर वाला गेम है, Dota 2 उसका फेवर वाला गेम है, तो अभी देखते हैं।
यही मेंटालिटी से आए थे U Cypher में कि हम आए हैं सिर्फ जीतेंगे, तो we are all prepared, all set for this.
Max will find that last auto attack and will find last first blood.
Gets glimpsed back here into the kinetic field. They've got the avalanche connecting onto Punk. Punk's gonna be the focus here. He will be brought down, and next they're focusing Appa. They want to fight nonetheless. The hoopstorm comes out on top of the toss. Punk is down. He has a secondary life available. It looks like he's gonna end up giving up that Aegis, but he does bring down Dream alongside.
Yakshas are moving for the finish. Kiko finds one kill onto Butter. SN has no choice but to man up, but this is not a fight he can win. The Yakshas have caught up to him. They're saving him for the bitter end, and the GG well played is called. The Akramaks just outplayed and outclassed by the Yakshas here.
Captain Akrid led his team to an important victory, making the Yakshas the first team to qualify for the finale. In the second semi-finale, it was the clash of the rivals. Marksmen versus the Sherdils.
Round 1. Fight.
Tekken was a hard-fought match, with Hans remaining unbeaten. Under Venom's captaincy, the marksmen won Counter-Strike to make it 5-3. As expected, the marksmen took cricket as well, and it was all down to Dota. Despite having a strong team, the marksmen fell to defeat at the hands of the Sherdils, making it 8-8.
आज का आपका मैच टाइम एंड हुआ. यहाँ पर चीजें ऐसे खत्म नहीं होती. We'll have a toss, जहाँ से ये पता लगेगा कि आप next game कौन से खेलोगे. But the twist is, the next game can only be a multiplayer game. That means either Dota 2 or CS:GO. If you win the toss, आप क्या लोगे?
CS.
जीता तो Dota.
Winning the toss, the marksmen chose Counter-Strike to be the tiebreaker. After an intense fight, the Sherdils turned it around, booking their spot in the finale.
At the end of a furiously engaging gameplay and a very close match, the score settled on 16-30 in the favor of the Sherdils. booking a one-way ticket for the Sherdils into our finals with the Yakshas.
If you're interested in participating in Season 2, send us your name, email, contact number, preferred game. If you're interested in shoutcasting, then send us your name, email, contact number, preferred game for shoutcasting. Attach a sample video or send us a link to view the same. In Season 2, there will be open qualifiers to enter. If you'd like us to come to your college to hold the qualifiers, send us your name, email, contact number, city, college name. Send us your details on info@usports.in and we'll get back to you.
For one last time in Ucypher Season 1, ready, set, fight!
We are the first and only team to score 100.
Yeah.
Jo bola tha sab hua hai and abhi aaj bhi hum hi jeetne wale hain.
तो आवारा कुत्ते भी मचा देते हैं, लेकिन असली दहशत एक शेर की होती है।